Hey guys, what's going on? It's Gil, aka Fisher of Man NY, and today I'm going to be showing you guys different techniques on how to successfully catch fluke, also known as summer flounder. Stay tuned guys, this is going to be a good one. Alright guys, so I think it's best if I show you guys the number one technique that I used last year, which gave me good numbers on catching fluke. Especially off the piers. So depending on where you're fishing and how the current is, I would usually use a 1 ounce bucktail. This is a 1 ounce sprol bucktail right here. I also like the sprols because if you decide to use the gulp, which I really don't use, but a lot of guys down there use gulp, there's a little clip right here that tends to hold the gulp very well. So that's one good thing about the sprol bucktails. I usually like to go with the green or the white. This is why you only see green and white. I actually tried the pink bucktails last year, but it usually just ended up me catching some sea robin. So I stuck with the white and the green, and it really produced very well. I like to use this snap. Just tie it either directly to your braid, or if you're using a fluorocarbon leader, you can tie that to your fluorocarbon leader. But this clip, I really like it. It's just because you can switch out your bucktails. Let's say if the green isn't working too good, you can switch to the white and etc. with the pink and all the colors that are out there. I really produced some good numbers last year with fluke, and the reason is because of these bucktails. Also, it's because I did not use the gulp. Even though gulp is really good when you go out for fluke, I stuck to bunker strips. You know, bunker strips release a lot of oil and scent into the water, so it attracts the fish very quickly. So if you go check on my channel, you'll see a video of me fluking. It's the West Marina video. The first clip is, you know, I dropped straight down with a bucktail and a bunker strip, and I just did a couple bounces and I got hooked into a keeper fluke. So another rig I like to use is the old-fashioned 3 foot leader to a hook, and from the hook I use some live bait. Last year the peanut bunker were very thick, so I would just cast net my own bait. Sometimes I would get some spearing, some baby snappers, but the peanut bunker just worked really well, so I would just use that. And I prefer using the bleeding bait hooks. This red hook, especially this one, this is a Daiichi, I think size 4. It's really good for fluke, especially the way that it's designed. Like, once the fluke just grabs onto it, it just hooks itself very well. So this is one of my favorite hooks to use for fluke. You can find these hooks in Sports Authority, and they're very affordable. It's like probably 5-pack hooks for $3, $4. It's not too bad. But from there, I would like to use a trolling sinker, depending where you are. Again, if the current is rough, you go higher, but a 3 ounce is pretty good to use down when you're fishing. So I would just tie that on with a simple clinch knot. And then that's it. You're ready to go. Just put your bait. You could either put live bait or you could just use a gulp. Gulp tends to work as well, but live bait, nothing's better than live bait. Another rig I like to use is one that I personally made, is my spinner blade rig, which has a squid skirt and also has a kind of hair teaser with some beads and some spinners. These spinners give great flash under the water. These work very well when you tip it with spearing or squid, or you can tip them as well with gulp. But this rig works very well. I've sold some of these rigs to some guys on the Facebook page, but you know, I've heard very good reviews from my rigs, and I personally have caught some nice fish with these rigs as well, especially off the boats. When you fish these off the pier, I would just recommend casting it out and doing a slow retrieve, just letting the spinner blades work itself in the water, especially with these nice flashy spinner blades with the hammer type design. Give some great flash in the water. So this is another great rig, especially. So you can find these squid skirts on eBay. Just type in squid skirts. You could probably find them 20 pack for $5 or less than that. You just gotta find them, either buy now or, you know, some people auction them off. So, you know, these are really great, especially with the flash and the way that they swim in the water. So these are another great addition to. I really prefer these trolling sinkers just because they have a swivel in which you can just tie your leader straight onto the swivel, and then you could tie your main line to the top. So this is one great way to fluke fish. So this is, I found these on eBay. Pretty affordable. I think it was depending on the weight too. So this is a 3 ounce. I think it came with 15 or 20 for 15 or 25 bucks. I don't remember, but you can easily just find them on eBay. Just type in trolling sinkers. I do a lot of my fluke fishing off piers, just to give myself a little challenge, because when you're on the boat, you know, you're bound to catch some fluke. But when you're on the pier, you know, there's, you just never know what you're gonna get. So I just love fishing off the piers, especially with bucktails. Just that initial hit when you're just bouncing straight up and down from the pier, it's just something that you gotta experience. So. Alright guys, I hope this information was helpful, and if you like this and if you think it really helped you out, please like, comment, subscribe. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. You can also reach me at fisherofman91@gmail.com. It'll be in the description below. And yeah, stay tuned for some more videos coming up. So thank you guys, and tight lines.